Hello and welcome back to the Reapers. So today we're in our beloved Mi-8 and we're going to look at the autopilot. It's all pretty simple as long as we do it properly. Like in most of the, well, all of the Russian planes, the autopilot is really good as long as you use it wisely. So we're going to look at the autopilot panel here. This is the stabilization autopilot. This is something we always want on. The green one in the middle should always be on. This is the heading autopilot, on and off. This is the altitude autopilot, on and off. Here's our test, and here are our adjuster knobs. So that, oh, and here shows the input that the autopilot is putting in the various controls, also shown at the top right of the screen here. And here is my controls, my manual controls here. So what we're going to do is take off and get in level flight, which will be in parameters to turn on the autopilot. So what I want to do is get in a position where I'm not having to use much rudder, i.e. going straight and at a relatively decent velocity. That's when I want to use the autopilot. I don't really want to try using the autopilot when I'm hovering around at a low speed with lots of rudder. Okay, so I'm just going to trim myself out. I'm a bit rusty with this plane. Let's just take off. Now, first thing to note is that the autopilot is driven, we believe, by a barometric altitude. So that means that it will not compensate for undulating terrain. So we don't want to try and fly over hills with this thing. So just to make it simple, we're going to pitch our nose down and fly out to sea, where we can't get anything wrong. So the faster I go, the less rudder input I'm going to need. And at some point, you can see at the top left, I'll need no rudder input at all. Sorry for that delay. Right, now we're going to turn the autopilot on. Heading autopilot on. Altitude autopilot on. So we can see what the autopilot's actually doing up here with my various controls, and it's gonna keep me on heading and keep me on altitude. Once it's settled, it can take a little while to settle. So just gonna give it a bit of time.
Also, don't forget to make sure your collective's in the right position. If it's too high, for example, the altitude autopilot will not be able to handle.
Do we have any more definite answers than that? What's too high?
+/-20%. That's what the autopilot can do.
Roger. So I don't really know how to describe that in terms of the little control that I've got at the top left. Basically,
what you want to do is just make sure you're roughly keeping level anyway and not gaining or losing a lot of altitude when you put in the altitude.
Yeah, so similar to using an SU-27 or an A-10 autopilot or something like that. You've got to get roughly in, you know, roughly flying level before you turn the autopilot on, otherwise it can't add enough control to actually work. That's the right thing to say, isn't it?
Yep.
So we can see that the autopilot is holding our heading there on what is 140, and it won't deviate. It will keep that as long as those lights are on. It's going to keep that. Our altitude, that is 70 meters barometric, and that is a radar altimeter of 95 meters, and it's keeping these held nicely. And our speed, it also keeps our speed, we believe. So that is keeping our speed at 212 kilometers an hour.
Basically, the altitude hold mostly works by controlling a collective. So if it wouldn't hold your speed as well, then you know, it wouldn't have the set position to hold.
Roger. Well, the next thing we're going to do is try the adjusters. So if I want to change my heading a bit, it doesn't give me much control. But if I want to change my heading a bit, if we're homing onto a long-range ADF station or something, and I want to change it to 150, and I don't want to have to take control back, then I can turn my knob here. I'm going to hover over that and use my mouse wheel to scroll right. And you can see the helicopter's banking a little, and we're slowly changing our course.
When you are doing that, do make sure to keep an eye on your altitude hold, because it can actually get overridden if you maneuver too much, which is entirely possible if you're changing your course.
Yeah, so one thing to just keep, make sure all these green, one thing I've learned about the MIA is just make sure the green lights are on, whichever ones you're using, because they tend to turn themselves off.
In the echelon left, by the way.
Roger. I'm just sorting my heading out. Okay, we've got ourselves on 150 there, and it's going to hold that. So next we're going to add some altitude. So you've got this selector switch forwards and backwards. Right click goes up, left click goes down. So I'm going to add a little bit of, why don't we go down? We're going to add some down. And it's taking us down to 500 meters. Oh, not too far, not too far, not too far. And why don't we go back up? Doesn't like going up very much. Okay, back up to 500 meters. Back up to 600 meters. Back up to 700 meters. Let go.
Stabilize.
Double check my lights haven't gone off. That's the key thing, to double check the green lights haven't gone off. And she's back up to whatever that is. She's stabilized. Let's see if we can get a little bit higher. One thing to note, this is very finicky and not particularly joyous to do.
It primarily depends, I think, on you having your collective in the correct position. If it's just slightly too low, for example, it will struggle climbing up.
Yeah, like the KF-50, I think. I'd say it's like the KF-50. Okay, that's there. I'm not going to mess with my collective at this point because I don't want to upset the autopilot for the sake of this video. So we're going to leave it at 400, I think it's settled. Right, so that was the altitude. Now let's have a look at the bank. So as well as the heading and the altitude, we can change the bank. So I'm going to try and show that, hopefully without crashing, on our artificial horizon and our actual horizon. So we're going to turn some bank on. And it wasn't really enough to see, so let's turn it a little more on. And you can definitely see the helicopter's banking. Now you can see our artificial horizon is banking. So before we crash, I'm going to turn that back to neutral. Where was neutral? About there. A little bit left. Left. Okay, we are pretty much wings level. A tiny bit more. Tiny bit more.
Altitude, you're really low.
I am low, aren't I? Oh, I've turned myself left. Hang on. Oh, sugar. I banked too much. Scratch it.
Like 20 meters off the water or something.
Yeah, it's... But I'm happy here. Charlotte's she'd leveled herself out, so... Okay, we're back finally to wings level. Next, what have we got? We've got pitch. Now, I'm quite low at the moment, so I don't want to pitch down. Remind me which way pitch is up, Stahl.
Clockwise is down, I think.
Clockwise is down, so I'm going to try going anti-clockwise on the pitch. Keep a good eye on my altitude, make sure I don't crash. Will this override the altitude then, Stahl?
It might, yeah, if you input too much control, it will.
Yeah, I see we're going up now. Yep, that's fine. So this is going to adjust our pitch. And we're still a little bit wings unlevel, so we're going to try going back just a little bit. We're going to head back to neutral for the pitch. Okay, now we're wings level and we're flying level. Good, so we've tried all of those adjuster knobs, they work. The altitude one's a bit finicky, I find, but they're going to need a bit of practice with that. Can I have just one autopilot on this, so like just heading or just altitude? Can I do that?
Absolutely, you can.
So I'm going to turn heading off and leave altitude on. Let's see what she does.
Although one thing to note, if you just have altitude on, chances are, you know, if you make any course adjustments, it's just going to turn itself off.
Roger. Okay, yeah, I see that. Yeah, with the heading off, obviously the heading is no longer held. So heading back on. Okay, so the next thing we're going to show is that if you put rudder input from... So our rudder is neutral at the moment, or near enough neutral. If I try and put rudder input in, then we're going to override the heading autopilot. So watch my rudder pedals. Rudder. And you can see the heading has gone. And leave the rudders back to neutral. And the heading autopilot comes back on. Have you got anything you want to say about that, Stahl?
Yeah, one important thing to note, that is not only when your rudders are neutral. It remembers your rudder position when you input, when you start using the autopilot, as well as your heading. So if you have some rudder input, you will have to hold the rudder input after you put in the autopilot. Otherwise, Roger. It will be off.
And I think that's why I was trying to say, make sure you're rudder neutral before you start messing with the autopilot. Otherwise, you're going to have to hold your rudder in a certain place for the entire flight, which will be kind of annoying.
But also the override is intermittent, so as soon as your rudder is in the correct position again, the heading autopilot will kick back in.
Roger. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to show is that I can put a load of stick input, cyclic input, into the bird, and the autopilots will stay on, and eventually, presumably, regain control. So I'm going to go nice and silly like this. Whee! Whee! And you see the autopilots have stayed on. And, hello, Shaw. And as long as we kind of, you know, get the bird roughly level, because the autopilots only have a certain amount of control, then they will eventually regain control of the bird. The only other thing is I'm going to show jamming my collective on, see what happens when I jam my collective on. So collective goes up, and that has cancelled the altitude pilot. That's what we're expecting, wasn't it, Stahl?
Yep.
So I would have to go collective neutral again, or collective so that we can manually get level flight, and then I would be able to turn the autopilot back on for the altitude. Okay? I think we've covered anything. Anything you want to add to that, Star?
Not that I can think of right now, no.
Roger. Right, I hope that helps. It's a little finicky and it takes a surprisingly high amount of practice, but go in your Mi-8 and try some autopiloting. Hope that helps, and see you later.